Doc, I don't know your view on this, but give us your first approximation, or maybe you've talked to your sources and know what happened. What are you hearing about what went on in Paris?
Alex, it's always a pleasure to come on your show, but let me tell you, I grew up in France, in Toulouse, and I'm looking at one of the cartoons, which literally implies exactly what is going to happen. We are always on alert, and we want to wish you a happy new year. Until the end of January, we have not been attacked so far. So from my point of view, this is a highly provocative newspaper, cartoon. It's not about freedom of speech. It is about provocation. It is about instigation. In the world of intelligence, this type of agitation, propaganda, and cartoon would require an attack by al-Qaeda. Whether it was a Yemeni or not, that's not as relevant as the fact that I think this is a major distraction, this attack, from the real problem that Hollande has in France, which is a major bankruptcy of the economy, the fact that Hollande has been a total disaster, the fact that socialism is a disaster, the unemployment is up into the 20s, the fact that euro is falling repeatedly, oil is going down. So this, to me, is nothing more than an opportune occasion for distraction, intentionally or unintentionally. It's not relevant. But the French have a very good intelligence system. It's called the deuxième bureau. They know exactly what to do. They know how to go in to after people. And they have anywhere from about 6 to about 15 million legal and illegal first, second, and third generation Moroccans, Algerians, and Maghreb Muslims. They know the problems are there, but the real issue at hand is not the freedom of speech. This is absolute nonsense. What this was, these cartoons, as I'm looking at them, are nothing more than incredible agitation propaganda on the part of the French, which reflects no ability to express freedom of
speech. So what is the point of the agitprop? We know
the agitprop was that to distract from a much major, much more severe problem. Europe is falling apart. France and Germany cannot get along. Germany has warned repeatedly under Merkel that France must remain under a steer program. France cannot do it. France is bankrupt in effect. Their sovereign funds are almost empty. They cannot maintain.
So are you saying Hollande or the French intelligence may have staged this?
Well, I don't know if they staged it, but they certainly allowed it to happen, because here's a cartoon that says so far, hey, we're okay until the end of January. And lo and behold, they got attacked just at the point.
And by the way, I haven't seen all those, and I don't speak French like you do.
I don't speak French, but if you look at the various cartoons, you can see this is far more than freedom.
Well, that's breaking news. I mean, can you tell me what issue that is so we can find it?
Well, it's the latest issue. It's literally the one that says, toujours attendons en France. That means attendez. That means wait, watch. We are okay till the end of January. We haven't been attacked so far. And literally, if that's not an invitation for an attack, either intentional or unintentional, I would be surprised.
Well, I mean, it did come out when this first broke 3 years ago that this facility is connected to the CIA and British intelligence. But, I mean, a lot of stuff's connected to intelligence.
Well, if this was intelligence, I would say this is very poor intelligence. Because when you do agitation propaganda, you don't really have to go out of your way and show a Muhammad, the holy prophet Muhammad, as a gay. You don't have to say that the Quran is shit. These are things that are totally beyond the realm of even effective intelligence. It shows a very low level of our effectiveness, be it French, British, or American, just the way we did in 9/11. This is, shows you such immaturity in terms of intelligence and in freedom of speech that, you know, this was just waiting to happen, whether it was intentional or not.
You are watching the best of The Alex Jones Show, weekdays from 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. Central. Watch live at InfoWars.com/show or become a member of InfoWarsNews.com and help us take resistance to the next level.